Matthew William Gilbert was born on July 25, 1862, in South Carolina. While the facts of his early childhood and young adulthood have been lost in history, we know that he was living in Florida by the end of the 19th century. From 1890 to 1892, he was the Reverend at Bethel Baptist Institutional Church, which was the first established Baptist church in Florida. Being a reverend was considered a high achievement for people during that time, especially for an African-American man. The African-American church was so significant to the African-American community because it was the heartbeat of the African-American community. This originated from slavery. With Sunday being the only day many slaves had off, they would use this time to congregate together and have church. They would put their best clothing on and enjoy each other's company while worshiping. Church gave slaves something to look forward to. It was an escape from the harsh realities of slavery. After the Civil War, the African American church continued to be very important to the African American culture. Various institutions such as educational centers, credit unions, schools, fraternal organizations, and businesses ran out of the African American church. As the reverend over a church, Matthew Gilbert possessed a huge amount of determination and leadership. In 1879, the Bethlehem Baptist Association founded a school in Live Oak, Florida, named the Florida Baptist Institute. In later years, Matthew Gilbert would become president reverend over the college. The college had a thriving start. It was a school for African-American students who were involved in the church. Unfortunately, there were white citizens in Live Oak who did not agree with African-Americans having education, which led to lots of racial uprisings. In April of 1892, an unknown gunman shot into one of the school building windows, which terrified many people. Although the gunman did not hit anyone, his message was clear. They did not want African Americans to get an education. Matthew Gilbert and other staff members decided that it would be best to move the school from Live Oak and head to Jacksonville, Florida. In Jacksonville, Matthew Gilbert then founded Florida Baptist Academy in the basement of Bethel Baptist Institutional Church in May of 1892. A woman by the name of Sarah Ann Blocker was one of the instructors, noting that African-American women also assisted in education for African-American students. There were still more changes to the Florida Baptist Academy. Eventually, the school was moved to Miami, Florida, and is still in operation today with the new name of Florida Memorial University. One thing to remember is that education was very significant to African-Americans because it was something that was denied to African-Americans for centuries in America. Slaves were not taught how to read or write because white Americans feared slave revolts against them. The generational effect of slavery was still evident in education decades later. Though African American students had schools, many lacked resources and they all were segregated from white schools. In the late 1920s, the African American community on the east side of Jacksonville decided that African American students needed a school building. In 1928, the Matthew W. Gilbert High School opened. Segregation in the United States schooling system ended after Brown v. Board of Education. This case outlawed segregation in schools because it violated the Equal Protection Law given under the 14th Amendment. Matthew Gilbert High School is now Matthew Gilbert Middle School. Matthew Gilbert was an early pioneer for African American education, establishing a college and being reverend over a large church. This is noteworthy because African Americans endured harassment, mistreatment, violence, and even death in order to be able to receive education. It is only fitting that Gilbert has a school named after him that is still in use today. Matthew W. Gilbert passed away on March 8, 1917, in Nashville, Tennessee. He was buried in Jacksonville, Florida on March 11, 1917. His memory still lives on.
Throughout Matthew Gilbert's life, he displayed remarkable leadership traits including determination, optimism, courage, and wisdom. He helped make it possible for African Americans in Florida to receive an education. If it were not for people like Matthew Gilbert paving the way, there's a chance that we wouldn't have many African American educators, doctors, warriors, and entertainers. Matthew W. Gilbert lived a life that demanded change and left a legacy.